Okay, Drew, thank you. As we were mentioning, we're live here in Fort Smith. It's the 15th anniversary of that deadly tornado that hit Fort Smith, Van Buren, and Madison County back in 1996. You know, that was a very scary night for people around here, but meteorologist Ross Ellis shows us one lesson was learned that saved many lives.
We're better prepared now than we were then.
Steve Pilts works for the National Weather Service in Tulsa, Oklahoma. He works in coordination with Doppler radar and storm chasers to make sure tornado warnings are issued timely and accurately. This is something that didn't happen as a 1996 tornado tore through downtown Fort Smith and Van Buren. One of the problems was getting accurate radar data in the river valley.
Well, there was actually a study just prior to the tornado that was released about a month before the storm that indicated that there really was a need to have additional radar coverage there in southwest Arkansas and southeast Oklahoma. So the decision to go forward with the radar was made actually before the storm.
As crumbled buildings were being rebuilt in the tornado aftermath, so was a brand new Doppler radar on the south side of Fort Smith.
The city of Fort Smith stepped in and did a great job in a lot of that aspect, getting the land available. And things moved really quickly that wouldn't have otherwise happened without the storm probably. And I think it was within right about a year we actually saw the radar come online.
Building the new radar was a team effort with one goal in mind, to get the dome built before the following severe weather season. It was a success.
I think, you know, when you can scan closer to the ground level, that always helps your confidence on what you're seeing.
Tornadoes form in the low to mid levels of a thunderstorm, and with the new radar scanning the sky, rotation can be picked up as low as 500 feet in downtown Fort Smith. In 1996, the lowest scanning level was 7,400 feet, which meant there was a lot forecasters couldn't see with radar. The new technology keeps everyone within an 80-mile radius safer.
There's better coverage now across most of northwest Arkansas because of the Fort Smith radar.
Lack of a communication was another huge problem during the 1996 tornado.
There's just not one or two ways to communicate across the region anymore. Now there's four or five, and we've just seen that explosion of technology, and we're trying to take advantage of as much of that as we can.
Today, Fort Smith and Van Buren help to lead the nation in emergency communication. Ross Ellett, 4029 News.
And the EF3 tornado touched down at exactly 11:12 p.m. April 21st, 1996, right here in downtown Fort Smith, and then, of course, moving on, doing $300 million of damage in the area.